In this video, I'm going to show you how to fix your header and footer. So the header is the area from this horizontal line to the top of your page, and the footer is the area from this horizontal line to the bottom of your page. Anything that remains in these areas will remain on each page and so on, so they'll show up on each page. So what we want to do is delete anything that's in the footer right now, because these elements we don't need. So now we can fix our header. So the first thing we're going to do is fix this image here. So to do so, we just need to click on it. And that brought up this menu here. We can go change the strip image here. You have two options. You can upload an image, or you can find one from Wix. And you can also go to your social media websites and pick them up from there as well. I'm going to show you how to upload an image first. So we'll pick the image that we want, and once that shows up, we will select it. So now it has a check mark and we know that we have selected it. We'll apply it, and that shows us the photo here. You'll notice that it's not looking very good. Its face is not showing up at all. So we'll want to go to this wheel here. It's called settings, and we'll go crop and edit. Once this shows up, we'll go to the crop button, and this, anything that's lighted will show up. So we just want to move it to an area where we want the photo to show up. So I like this area, so I'm going to apply that and save. Alright, so this looks a little bit better now. So the other option is to use the Wix images, and if you decide you want to change the photo, you can just change it here. Or at a later time, it's back at this wheel button after you've already selected the strip image. So we'll go change, and let's go delete these. Now we can go to free from Wix. Once we're here, we can scroll down if we want and find an image that we want. I'm just going to choose the foggy pier and apply it. All right, so now we can change the name of our site. To do so, you need a text that's already there. Most templates will have it. If you've chosen something that is blank, you might want to go add it from this button. And then, of course, select either a title or this large heading. And all you need to do is just click. And then once you have it, you can edit from here. But I'm going to delete this since I already have a text. Alright, so now I'm going to click here and edit text. This has highlighted it, so now we know that we can fix whatever's highlighted. So you can name this whatever you want. Something really generic that I always suggest is just using people's names. So I'm going to use Victoria's ePortfolio. And you can get really creative and do something more fun, like learning adventures. So it's up to you as to what you want to do. If you're satisfied, you can move on to changing the box. But I'm going to show you how to change your font size and color. So first you have to have it highlighted. Once it's highlighted in blue, you can go change the font here. So you have a bunch to choose from, and you can just pick the one you want. Then you can go change the size. And don't worry if it looks kind of awkward right now. We will go resize that so that it fits more appropriately later. This is where you can change the color. And this is showing me what the site colors are for my ePortfolio right now. And if you don't like these colors, you can go change them at that link. You can go choose a palette that you want. So I'll select this one. And you can even change individual colors. So I can change this pink to a purple instead. And what I want to do is just add it. And then I can click done. So that has changed the theme colors on my page. But it still hasn't changed the text color. So we'll go back to color and choose the color that we want. If you want to choose a color outside of your site colors, you just need to click this button here, and then you can select the color you want or add a hex code. All right, so the next thing you want to do is resize your text box so that it fits the box that you have if you want to keep the box. All right, so one thing that I want you guys to notice is that only the text box is being selected right now. If I want to change anything about this box, I have to click on the box itself. From here, I can change the design of the box by clicking on this button. And this will allow me to choose different colors and even different shapes. So I can do that there. But what I want to do is actually get rid of this box. So what I'm going to do is delete it. But even though this is selected now, it may delete our text if we delete the entire thing, as you've seen right there. So what we want to do is detach the elements from each other before deleting the element that we don't want. So now I can move this to an area that I want it. You can see that there are purple lines everywhere when I move it around. These lines will help you to center them and align them correctly on your page. So for example, right now it's telling me that this is centered horizontally and vertically. And we know that because the lines are running across each other. And now you'll notice that there is a gap between the menu and the header itself is quite large. So what we want to do next is fix that. The first thing we probably want to do is make it so that the header isn't so huge. And the thing that we need to do is just to move the menu. There are two ways to move things. And the first way is to just drag things, as you can see. So this doesn't move anything else except that except the element that I am moving. If you do it this way, it will require extra steps because you will have to move everything below it. So the best thing to do is to use these drag handles here. This keeps all of the elements above or below in place so that you don't have to move them. And now we just have to make the image hit the header. All right, so I'm liking how this looks. I would say at this point we are probably done with our header and footer, and we can save.